What do you do when you doubt the goodness of God? You meditate on the promises of God. Promises like, what the enemy means for evil, the Lord means for good. Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. I would have despaired, but I believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he will strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. For those who wait on the Lord, they'll renew their strength. They'll mount up with wings like eagles. They'll run and not grow weary. They'll walk and not faint. For the Lord has appeared to me of old, saying, yes, I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn you. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask whatever you desire in my name, and it will be done for you. His banner over me was love. Turn to the strongholds, you prisoners of hope. Even today do I declare that I will restore double unto you. Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be opened unto you. For if God did not spare his only son, will he not also with him freely give us all things? We take up the helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, the shield of faith, which can quench every fiery dart of the wicked one, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt of truth, the shoes of the preparation of the gospel of peace. Fight a good fight, wage a good warfare, because neither life nor death, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, neither height nor depth, nor any other created thing can separate you from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. We are more than conquerors through him who loves us. We have not received the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of a sound mind. We have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but the spirit of adoption by whom we cry, Abba, Father. And his spirit testifies with our spirits that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If indeed we suffer with him, we will also be glorified together. For we glory in tribulation, knowing that tribulation produces patience, patience experience, experience hope, and hope maketh not ashamed, because of the love of God which is spread abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost which is given unto us. So stand fast in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. For whether I'm hungry or full, suffering or abounding, I have learned to be content. For I can do all things through him who strengthens me. My God shall supply all your needs according to the riches of glory by Christ Jesus, who the Bible says is the King of kings, the Lord of lords, Emmanuel, Messiah, the Prince of peace, the Son of God, the bread of life, the light of the world, the way, the truth, the life, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the door for his sheep, the shepherd who lays down his life for his lambs, the vine who gives fruit to his branches, the word of God made flesh, the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning, the end, the resurrection, and the life, the Prince of the kings of the earth, the Amen, the root of David, the man-child, the beginning of God's creation, he who holds the double-edged sword, he who wields the bright and morning star, the captain of our salvation, the image of the invisible God, and the anchor of hope. I'm just saying. So think like a proton and be positive of the goodness of God.